Dear colleagues, good afternoon for you and good morning for us. Thank you very much for the opportunity to share this meeting with you, this PDR. The idea of this short presentation, especially after lunch for you, is to show how we are working in Argentina, monitoring our part of the South Atlantic Ocean from the space in both directions, upstream and downstream activities. To begin, we want to share with you the summary of our satellite mission with different contribution of coastal and ocean studies. SAC-C, the first operative satellite in 2000, then SAC-D, specific for sea surface salinity, both mission in cooperation with NASA, and now the current mission, SAUCOM, two satellites in L-band, also in cooperation with the Space Agency of Italy, and the future under developing now Saviamar mission, focused especially for ocean and coast. Then, during the presentation, I want to talk about some specific issues about this mission. Only to show you some products, on the left you can see SAC-C products along the our sea, specific blooms or specific features in the coast, or our La Plata River with a very high amount of sediments. If we see on the right, we have the different products of the SAC-D Aquarius mission. The main product of this mission was the sea surface salinity from the Aquarius instrument from NASA, and other parameters on the ocean like rain, wind, water vapor, sea ice in the polar region, and CCT. These other parameters were provided by different instruments constructed in Argentina. This mission was really an observatory for ocean, climate, and environment. Now we are with our SAUCOM One mission, our STAR mission. This mission has two satellites, SAUCOM A1A, launched in 2018, and the second one launched in August the last year in 2020. The main focus of this mission is the generation of data for soil moisture maps dedicated to agriculture and forestry activities. But the data are very useful for maritime surveillance, hydrology, oceanography, emergency like flood, drought, and earthquake. Natural resources and environment, urban area, cartography, and also health. This mission is compound by two satellites, like with SAR instrument on board in L-band, and the possibility to generate a quad pole data. And the SAUCOM is part of the CIASGE mission, the CIASGE constellation, with other mission in cooperation with ASI, the Space Agency of Italy, with the COSMOSKYMET in other SAR instrument who works in X bands. So for us it's important this mission, not only to national level, but to international aspect. Now we are working in CONAE, the Space Agency of Argentina, in Saviamar. Saviamar is a satellite dedicated full for ocean. The main application is related to fishing and surveillance in the ocean, aquaculture activities, coastal and inland water studies, and specific detection of harm blooms in the sea, and also provide some specific information related to climate change. To do that, we need to develop the main products that you can see on the left: emerging radiance from the sea surface, chlorophyll A estimation, turbidity, attenuation coefficient, radiation available for photosynthesis, the PRR, and sea surface temperature. The mission has two scenarios. One is a global scenario with 800 meters of spatial resolution with a revisit of 2 days, every 2 days, and a coastal scenario with 200 meter resolution. Is now actually the possibility of this coastal scenario is only for South America. We hope that in the future we can provide this kind of data with 200 meters for other parts of the world, but we need some cooperation, international cooperation related to the ground station to receive the data. You can ask, okay, which are the motivation for Argentina with all this mission related to ocean and sea and earth observation? For us, it's important from the beginning of the creation of CONAE, the National Space Plan. This plan is our guide of our activities. We need to provide data and information for strategic areas, for strategic and benefit areas, like a productive area, social and environmental areas. For this, we need to provide data. Other important initiative in this motivation is Pampa Azul. Pampa Azul is an initiative who appeared in 2013 from the national government, and this initiative promotes technological innovation applicable to the sustainable exploitation of natural resources and the development of the industry related to the sea. We want to promote the presence in the South Atlantic with data and science. This initiative is important because many organizations from the different sectors of the government and the private sector participate. The universities, the research institute, this private sector, high-tech technology companies, and the end users of this information participate of this initiative. And finally, for us, it's important the extension of the external limit of our continental shelf that it was approved in United Nations 6 or 5 years ago. So we have more ocean to monitor. If we consider the Argentina international motivation, Argentina and CONAE specifically participate in the different approach of the ocean community. We are part of the International Ocean Color Coordinating Group. We are part of CIOS, and also participate in COPWAS, the area of space in United Nations. We provide information related to the Sustainable Development Goals. We work with NASA, with NOAA, with ESA, and also we are part of the ANCHOR initiative. So these are our great motivation for sea and ocean observation. But CONAE, to do all of these activities, is not alone. So we have in our country really a technological space team with people belong to scientific sector and also private sector. These are an example in case of INVAP. INVAP is a high tech company and is the main contractor of our missions. All the mission that I mentioned before was built in cooperation with INVAP. And other example is SpaceSUR. We worked several years ago with SpaceSUR, working in application, in support to ground station, and the design and maintenance of platform for data distribution, like is the example with SAOCOM data. And the other logos that you can see here is part of this ecosystem. So we work in this way with all the actors in our country. Well, some specific area very strong in CONAE is the capacity building. CONAE has PhD and master programs, courses about remote sensing, training, specification, or courses very specificated for professional and technician. So because we need to capacitate to training the people to use the information and also to think in innovation from the technological point of view. Some other example of this capacity or training here you can see in the slide. Well, the products, the data, and the end users are our focus finally. So I want to present in this example one of our main end users, INIDEP. INIDEP is the National Institute of Research in Fisheries. We work together since many years ago, and this is only an example, the fishery monitoring related to the vessels who are focused on the squid in our sea, in the boundary in between water, national and international waters. So people from INIDEP develop different applications, for instance, in this case, to monitor the frequency of vessels along the continental shelf. Also, we cooperate with them in capacity building, in workshop and training courses. And also now they are working very hard with SpaceSUR in marine litter, specifically with microplastic, identifying the areas, the potential areas of accumulation of this litter, considering the oceanic fronts. So I think that the future is there. Other applications are only to mention dedicated to aquaculture, working with the Ministry of Agriculture, Livestock and Fishing in our country, operative monitoring of water quality in different continental waters with different institutions, field campaigns with spectroradiometer, and detect specifically the monitoring of harm hubs or harm algae blooms. So these are some examples on also the cooperative application with SAR data. In this case, we work with the prefecture of Argentina. They have the very automatically detection with CONAE data from SAUCOM or from COSMO, and also with ISA with the use of Sentinel. So in this case, I want to show, I don't know what happened. An image of SAUCOM. You can see these all bright points, spots are vessels related to squid fishery. Other example is the application related to oil spill monitoring in different parts of our coast. We detect the event, the potential oil spill, and generate a report for different institutions, like you see on the right, Ministry of Environment, Navy, Naval Prefecture, and other end users. And also SAUCOM has presence in Antarctica. We give support to the Antarctic campaign, to our institution. And here you can see like a bright point, the icebreaker, IRISAR, and we follow it along the campaign. And also we work with different groups of Antarctica, for instance, monitoring the iceberg when they broke during the summer. This image was the last 2 weeks with the broken ice in Antarctica. And the regional cooperation is also very important. It's only some examples related to activities with Peru, with Chile, with Colombia, related to emergencies, to SAR applications in the ocean, search and rescue in the sea. So for us, the regional cooperation, it's important, and CONAE has a long story with these countries cooperating in cooperation. And finally, our future challenges. now we are working in LBAN-SAR application, and we want to finish them very, very soon. Work on the integration information, X and L-bands, merge optical and radar data, works on the data cube, SAR and optical for Argentina. It's important for us, has a good interfaces with the end users, and the data availability, work on the thematic geoportal and open access for all this data. We continue working on the new application of Saviamar and Calval activities, and it's a challenge, it's very special, the continue working in data science and technological innovation in both sense, again, upstream and downstream the data. So I think that that's all for my presentation, and thanks again for the opportunity, and thank you very much.